Well, it has cost millions to police, left hundreds of officers injured. Now the full impact of the disorder on our streets has emerged. Police have arrested fewer people suspected of ordinary crime. They claim because they have had to divert resources. Well, tonight we also speak to an officer injured on the front line. Our correspondent Sharon O'Neill has the story.
It's been a long, hot, often fraught summer, with some of the worst rioting in years. Now the full cost has emerged. The bill for trying to keep the peace here since April stands at £15 million. And the cost of this ongoing protest in North Belfast, £50,000 a day.
Over the last couple of weeks, the cost of that 300 yards of space has been just under £500,000. Now that's £500,000 on 150 police officers every night who aren't being deployed somewhere else. They're taken from crime teams, from organised and serious crime branches. They're taken from CID teams. They're taken away from burglary, from domestic abuse, from a range of other normal crime investigations that we want to get back to quickly.
Not only that, the number of officers injured in just 12 months trying to hold the line, almost 700.
I think the Chief Constable needs to ensure that the policing board, that the Justice Minister and the Secretary of State for Northern Ireland, who's got a responsibility for national security in this part of the UK, that they all have a grasp of how serious a problem this is and that there is a potential crisis looming. We cannot go on like this. We just cannot.
The news of just how much this has cost the PSNI revealed at the first policing board meeting held since those events over the summer. And now those injured on the front line are also speaking out. This female officer does not want to be identified. We have also changed her voice to protect her identity. She has been injured on four occasions, the last time here in the Woodvale on the 12th. She was hit on the head with a large piece of masonry.
They threw it over the Land Rover. It hit the water cannon, bounced off and hit me on the back of the head. It was very sore, but I kept going. We're all the same. You are used to people throwing 20 metres away from you. There haven't been that many incidents where they've been so close to your shield. They were right up beside you. They were using swords. It was the worst I've ever probably had to deal with.
Divisions at interfaces like this one in North Belfast run deep. And if history shows us anything, it is that there is no quick fix. The protests here still going. All the financial resources being pumped into policing contentious marches and protests are funded by the public purse. It's money senior officers would much rather see spent on fighting ordinary crime.
It's affecting our arrest figures, it's affecting crime figures, and I don't want to exaggerate the import of this as well, but you know, we've made 3,500 less arrests over the course of the last 9 months compared to last year because we've had to commit such a significant part of our resource base to keeping communities safe and doing the interface management.
But people here in Tweddle Avenue, camping out over that decision not to allow the Orange Order to pass our doing, believe the cost is justified.
This camp's totally peaceful. There's not been one arrest at this protest camp ever since it started. So it's a policing bill has got to be there for health and safety, but there's no trouble coming from here.
So you think it's justified?
Oh yes. What price can you put in your civil rights?
There is a simple and clear alternative. Compare the cost of the last 6 months with the cost of getting the parade up on the 12th of July every year in the last 10 years. Simple solution, the parade of allowing the lodges and bands to return is the cheapest option, always was the cheapest option.
Away from here, deep concern that the financial impact could go far beyond policing. And even if the PSNI were to look for more money, they may not even get it.
It would be in all of our interests if we didn't spend all this money in policing, but we actually reinforced the health service, reinforced the job creation agencies. There's so much more we should be doing.
689 police officers have been injured since last July. The strain is taking its toll on the force as a whole. The call for more officers, not a new one.
As things go on, more and more people are off with injuries and the units are getting smaller and smaller. And you just wonder if the numbers are there to deal with it if something big happens. I enjoy my job. Yes, it is a given you end up dealing with rats. I think what has happened is the intensity of it. But sometimes you do worry. Can your body take much more?
So, the physical and financial drain now fully clear. Until a solution can be found, police can only do what they can. For them, those political talks with US diplomat Richard Haass to try and find a resolution to the parades issue can't come soon enough.
Well, you can let us know what you think about the cost of policing parades and protests in Northern Ireland. Just log on to our website, u.tv, and leave your comments.